You sure did a good job running the McGillicuddy twins out of town.
So that's who it was. I thought it was the same fella twice.
Sheriff, ain't that new preacher arriving in town today?
Yeah, that's right. What this town needs is a preacher man. Someone the town folk can turn to for spiritual guidance. Somebody who can put a stop to all this gambling and womanizing. A good man. An honest man. A man of God.
Your face. Oh, what a bleeding dump. Here, son, do you want to make a contribution to the church fund? Hey, come on. Right, that should get me pissed tonight. All right, say, Colin, let's have a beer down here, eh?
Coming right up, stranger.
That's right, yeah, lovely. Blimey, has the price gone up since you served me? Thanks very much. Cheers.
Say, who are you, stranger?
Good, you've got some ugly-looking women here, haven't you? Well, I'm the new preacher, as a matter of fact.
Where are you from, partner?
Partner? We're not married, are we? I'd have remembered you. I'd have remembered that tongue, anyway. No, I'm from a one-horse town.
Why did you leave?
Somebody shot the horse. That finished my fun on a Friday night.
Nah, what the old-timer means is what brings you to Tombstone.
Tombstone? Ooh, that's a depressing name for a place, isn't it? What's the next town along called, then? Bleeding Miseryville. Here, let's have a game of cards.
Yeah, but you're a preacher man!
Yeah, and you're overacting. That doesn't stop us playing cards, does it? A little special shuffle here. Here we go. All right, we'll see you again. Here we go.
Hey, these cards are marked.
Well, of course they're marked. That's how you play the game. Look, there's a seven of hearts. There's a three of hearts. You wouldn't be able to play if it was all blank, would you?
I reckon the old-timer should deal.
Yeah, go on, then.
Ready? One for you, and one for you, and one for me. And one for you, and one for you, and one for me. Yeah.
Twist.
Talk about building up your part, blimey.
Bust.
Twist. 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 There we are, 108.
21! Sorry, son. Wait a minute. This here's fool's gold!
Yeah, that's why you've got it. Right. Another beer, I think. Come in, let's have another beer up here. Oh, I can't wait all night for this. I'll use my magnet. Here we go. Love it. Cheers.
What brings you to town, preacher man?
Oh, I'm here on a cat drive.
Don't you mean cattle drive?
No, I've got 1,000 head of tabby outside. Hell of a job branding them. You got to lift the tail and mark their owner's name with a red hot iron. Luckily, his name's O'Leary, so that saves a letter. Do you know what I mean?
Listen, stranger. This town ain't big enough for two preachers.
If you carry a Bible, you've got to be prepared to use it.
I'll use it all right.
Give him an headache in the morning, that was 60% proof. Morning.
Morning, sir. I've had a tip off that those toffees have been stolen.
Of course they haven't been stolen. There they are there, look, do you see?
Well, thanks for clearing that one up.
That's all right.
Sorry to have troubled you.
Always a pleasure to help the police.
Newspaper, please.
Here we are, Fruttons. What's this?
22nd of October 1954?
That's right, today's newspaper.
This is 40 years out of date.
Oh, I see what's happened. You've fallen asleep in your armchair and you're having a dream. You're dreaming it's the 1990s.
It doesn't feel like a dream to me.
Well, I can show you. Is this the sort of thing that happens in real life?
Could be a dream, I suppose.
You're still not convinced?
Not really.
How about this?
No, you're right. This is the same dream that I have every night. Any moment now...
Excuse me, can I have a bag of toffees, please?
Oh, it's got to be a dream.
No, he's a regular customer.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you both, but actually, this is my dream. At this very moment, I'm having a nap on the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean.
How do we know it's your dream?
I don't like toffees.
Well, she's a bit of all right, isn't she? Right. Tomorrow morning at 10:30, we are going to rob Barclays Bank in the High Street. Now, 2 minutes before 10:30, I want you, Terry, to park the getaway car here on the corner of Anscot Road.
Yeah, but that's a double yellow line.
Don't worry about that. We'll only be in the bank for a couple of minutes.
You say 10:30?
Yeah.
It's a traffic warden. Yeah. Has his breakfast in that snack bar there. Every morning at 10:30. You park there, he'll nick it.
All right, we'll park on this bit of waste ground here, look.
No, you can't do that. They're building a new Tesco's there.
I must say, it's about time. If I want to do any shopping, I've got to go all the way up to the arcade here, look.
If we can't park there, and we can't park there, where are we going to park?
Now, I'll tell you what we do. We'll have to make sure that traffic warden doesn't have his breakfast at 10:30.
Well, how are we going
to
do that?
We'll nobble him.
Where does he live? He lives in Pollen Lane, down here. Here we are. Number 27.
How's he afford a place like that on traffic warden's money?
I don't know. His grass needs cutting, though.
Well, never mind that. What are we going to do about this traffic warden?
Well, suppose you pour a load of concrete down his front path,
yeah? Yeah, use this porridge.
Sorry. Comes out of his house in the morning, walks down his front path. Look, he's covered in concrete. That slows him down. Oh, no. It's stuck on my feet. I don't know. Very heavy, though. I'm starving. Here I am. By the time he gets to the snack bar, it's 11:30.
Nuck. We'll just go through the car wash here, look.
What you want to do is keep him awake all night so he can't get up in the morning.
How are you going to do that?
Here's his ass here, right? He sleeps up in the front bedroom. You break through the side window into his living room and you put a record on the stereo. Walk in the Black Forest. And then you hide behind the sofa. He wakes up. Blimey, what's all that racket? He comes downstairs. Turns the stereo off. And you keep that up all night.
No, that won't work. You had the builders in last year. Here we go. He's let the downstairs out to these people that have all-night parties. He thinks upstairs with cotton wool in his ear, so nothing will wake him up.
I've got an idea. We'll keep him awake by shining a light through his bedroom window.
How are you going to do that?
Well, you set up a huge reflector here to pick up the beam from the lighthouse over here.
He might not see that light coming through his bedroom window.
Of course he will. Look, here's his head, right? The light comes into his eye through the corner, hits his retina, is converted into electrical impulses which travel along the optic nerves into the visual cortex in the back of the brain here, so he can't get to sleep.
Blimey, you think of everything.
Right, that solves the problem of how we're going to park that car on the double yellow lines at 10:30. And this time tomorrow morning, we shall be very rich men indeed. Well, that's got to be one of the smoothest bank jobs I've ever pulled. Now for the share out. One for you. One for me.